Hi everyone. So some last set of questions. Let's take a look. What are the pros and cons of using promises instead of callback, right? So if we avoid using callback, it means we can avoid the callback hell. Promises makes it easy to write the sequential asynchronous code, like you can use a chaining using promise dot then dot then dot then. It is also easy to write the code in the parallel also. If there are independent promises, then you can just do the promise dot all. And there are different other libraries available to do that, like async is there, bluebird promises and all. With promises, these scenarios which are present in callbacks, only coding will not happen, like call the callback too early, call the callback too late, call the callback too few, too many times. This will not happen. Cons: slightly more complex code. In older browsers where ES2015 is not supported, there we need to use the polyfill. This is only the cons I see. Otherwise, everything is good. You should use the promises. Why would you use something like the load event, and what is the advantage, disadvantage, and what is a DOM content loaded event? So there are two events, load event and DOM content loaded event. The load event fires at the end of document loading process. At this point, all the objects in the document are in the DOM and all the images, scripts, links and subframes have finished loading. So this is the load event. The DOM event, DOM content loaded event will fire after the DOM for the page has been constructed. So this is like everything has been processed. The DOM is ready, but do not wait for other resources to finish loading. This is the preferred in certain cases where you do not need the full page to be loaded before initializing. So DOM content loaded means DOM resources are loaded, but you don't have to wait for other resources to get downloaded. Then in that case, you can use DOM content loaded, or load event is once everything is done, then that is getting fired. Okay, these questions we have already covered. What is use strict? So good question. You might have seen this in ES6 code or ES5 code you might be using. Use strict at the beginning of the function declarations or at the top of the file, right? So what the use strict is doing, make it impossible to accidentally create a global variable. So if you are creating any variable without var keyword, by default, it gets added in the global scope. But if you are using use strict, it will not get added. Any variable will not go into the global scope from that file. Makes assignment which would otherwise silently fail to throw an exception. Okay, so using use strict makes an attempt to delete undeletable properties. Simple thing, requires the function parameters name to be unique. This is undefined in the global context, right? So whenever you try to access this object inside a simple function, this object represents the window object, but when you put a use strict, then it will represent undefined, because now use strict is a wall of China. It is not allowing you to access the global scope or the window object, or it will not allowing you to populate some values inside the global scope. Okay, what is the difference between attribute and property? This is a small question. Like this is the input type text field, right? If you try to get the property and value, document.query selector input, and then from the input you can get attribute value or input.value. They will give you the hello property both, because value is representing hello. But when you change the text field and you added the value world, in that case the get attribute value will still points to hello, but value will give you the exact result, which is hello world. This is kind of weird, but this is how it is. Okay, let's see more on the next videos.